This is the second video we publish about the most interesting places in Moscow. Some time ago, we launched our first selection, Top 10 Moscow Must-See Tourist Attractions. The video, what has been a success. Both on ciceroneplus.com and YouTube, we have received many requests to expand the selection with other interesting places in Moscow. By the way, thank you very much for sending us your suggestions and comments. Now, we present our new video, Moscow Top 10 Amazing Places. Places what will surprise you for its beauty, for its importance, or its meaning. Although some of them are not yet well known, especially outside of Russia. We start the countdown.
Number 10. Museum of Cosmonautics.
Close to the Museum of Cosmonautics, you can see a titanium rocket of more than 100 meters, the monument to the conquerors of space. In the Museum of Cosmonautics, you can become acquainted with the history and the future of space exploration. In this museum, you'll find many of the landmarks of world astronautics, or as we say in Russia, cosmonautics. For instance, the famous Sputnik, the first satellite that orbited around the Earth in 1957. By the way, Sputnik in Russia means satellite. Sputnik 2, released only 1 month after the first, and where the unfortunate dog Laika was traveling. The first animal that orbited around the Earth. Space suit of Yuri Gagarin, the first man who traveled to space and returned to Earth in 1961. The replica of the famous Luna 9 space probe, the first probe that managed to reach the moon in 1966. The replica of Venus 4, the first probe to reach the atmosphere of Venus, and fulfilled his mission successfully in 1967. The models of famous piloted space stations, Soyuz, meaning in Russian Union, and Mir, that in Russian means peace.
Number 9. Izmailovo, Kremlin.
We are in the Kremlin in Izmailovo. The Kremlin is a cultural and leisure complex in Izmailovo, was founded in 2003. The Palace of Russian Food is an architectural fantasy, inspired among others in the wooden Palace of Kolomenskoye, built for Alexei Mikhailovich Romanov in the 17th century, the century of the culmination of wooden architecture in Russia. The Temple of St. Nicholas is the spiritual center of the Kremlin in Izmailovo. Its height reaches 46 meters, and it is considered the tallest wooden temple of Russia. The bell tower of the Kremlin in Izmailovo has a collection of bells from the 17th to the 20th centuries that not only can be heard, but also learn how to play the bells. Here you can find a great market with traditional Russian products. Such as samovar, a symbol of Russian culture that serves to make tea. Matryoshkas, the multicolored wood carving dolls that hide inside each other. Russian icons and other objects of Orthodox worship. You can also visit interesting museums, such as the Vodka Museum.
Number 8. Moscow City.
Moscow City is the international business center of Moscow, where you can visit a small museum and enjoy the most spectacular views of the capital. Moscow City is located on the bank of the Moscow River. The Bagration Bridge is a pedestrian bridge with shops that joins the main shore of the complex with the only tower located on the opposite shore, Tower 2000. Highlights the duo of towers federation, one of which with 95 floors and 373.7 meters high, in 2014 it became the tallest building in Russia and Europe. We also found the Evolution Tower, with its original spiral shape reminiscent of a DNA molecule.
Number 7. Manezh.
Manezh Square is located in the historic center of Moscow, next to the Kremlin. It takes its name from the beautiful building of Manezh, in Russian, horse riding building, because that was its initial use. The building was designed in the early 19th century by Agustin de Betancourt, the Spanish inventor and the engineer of road. The building was born in 2004 and later rebuilt. It's currently used for exhibitions and artistic events. Under a renovated square is located the large underground shopping center, Ochotny Ryad, whose glass domes arise on the surface of the square. Over the central dome highlights the equestrian statue of Saint George, patron of Moscow. In its inner face, it reproduces a map with the time zones, hence its denomination of world clock.
Number 6. Gorki Park.
The Culture and Leisure Park was opened in 1928. In 1931, it was renamed Park Gorki. Until the 19th century, its current territory was on the outskirts of Moscow. The popular public park is located along the Moskva River. The main entrance is the monumental structure of 18 meters, was built in 1955. In the same year, the fountain of the central wall was installed in its current location. One of the most romantic places in Gorki Park is the complex of Galitsinsky ponds, dated from 1954. In the ponds, we can see and listen to nice ducks. The beautiful rose garden of the park exhibits different species of roses. The Neskuchny Sad is a historic garden, was full of large estates since the middle of the 18th century until the mid-19th century. The name of this garden means in Russian, no boring garden. Currently, in its territory, you can see some buildings of the past epochs. For example, Count Orlov's summer house, built between 1804 and 1806.
Number 5. GUM.
The current name Universal State Store, or GUM, it's a Soviet heritage. It was built on the place where it was traditionally held commercial activity in Moscow. Its main facade, located in front of Red Square. The previous commercial galleries in Moscow were demolished, given the deterioration they suffered. They were replaced by the new building, opened in 1893, the project of the architect Alexander Pomerantsev. You can see the facade of the pseudo-Russian style and indoors an important glass and steel wall. Designed by the innovator engineer of his time, Vladimir Shulkhov. GUM is currently a large shopping center, where many of the most luxurious brands of the world are housed. The facade of the main building is over 240 meters long. The galleries communicate by cantilever bridges. The fountain in the center of GUM was rebuilt in 2007.
Number 4. Tsaritsyno.
Let's see Tsaritsyno. Tsaritsyno is a beautiful museum reserve with a park of more than 400 hectares. In the past, the museum reserve is a place where works of art are displayed near Moscow for Empress Catherine II, who went down in history as Catherine the Great. In 1775, Catherine II buys the village Chornaya Grad and change your nothing attractive name, which in Russian means black mud, by the name Tsaritsyno. The architect of the court, Vasily Bashen, received the order to build the new residence of the Empress. The construction of the building complex of Bashenov's residence project lasts 10 years. In 1785, Catherine II visits Tsaritsyno and replaces Bashenov by his student and assistant, Matvey Kazakov. The cause of the change is not due to Yekaterina's test. Indeed, It is due to Bajenov's relationship with Freemasonry, who supported the transfer of power to his son Pablo. The architect Kazakov completely disassembled the Grand Palace, already finished, and built a new one, with some typical elements of the style of the castles. The construction lasts until 1796, the year of Yekaterina's death, and continues with a period of deterioration of almost 200 years. In 1987, the works of restoration of old buildings begin. In 2007, it officially opens the reconstructed museum reserve, Tsaritsyno.
Number 3. Kolomenskoye.
Old village on the outskirts of Moscow, Kolomenskoye, is known from the early 14th century. Located on the high bank of the Moscow River, it was the summer residence of the Grand Dukes of Moscow and Tsars of Russia. Near the Moscow River, in the northeast part of the enclosure, is the Museum of Outdoor Wooden Architecture. The famous Ascension Church of the 16th century, the main and most beautiful building of Kolomenskoye, was built during the reign of Tsar Basil III to commemorate the birth of his son, Ivan IV the Terrible. It was declared a World Heritage Site by UNESCO in 1994. Behind me, you can see the reconstruction of the palace of Alexei Mikhailovich. The palace, originally from the second half of the 17th century, was disassembled by the order of Catherine the Great in the second half of the 18th century due to its deterioration. Thanks to the fact what may have been preserved with detailed plans of it, its reconstruction could be carried out. The new palace was opened in 2010. Now is located in the southern part of the enclosure. It's worth visiting the current palace of Alexei Mikhailovich, which recreates 24 of Tsar's rooms with authenticity and accuracy.
Number 2. Pushkin Museum.
Located in the center of Moscow, there is the Pushkin State Museum of Fine Arts, but known as the Pushkin Museum. The Pushkin Museum collections represent the main stages of art history, from the ancient civilizations until the beginning of the 21st century. His world-famous collection of French painting includes paintings by Paul Cézanne, Claude Monet, Pierre-Auguste Renoir, or Paul Gauguin. Among the famous representatives of other countries are Pablo Picasso from Spain or Diego Rivera from Mexico. Before revealing the number one of our selection, they offer three special mentions. The 0 kilometer of Russia, taken as a reference to measure distances on the roads that leave Moscow to carry off to all places in the country. It's next to the Iberian Chapel and the Resurrection Gate, through which you access the Manezh Square from the Red Square. It's a symbolic 0 kilometer, indicated by bronze plates, in which we have represented 12 typical animals of Russia. Zaryadye Park is the new great park of Moscow of the 21st century, opened its doors in 2017. It has numerous attractions, among which stands out a viewpoint of the Moscow River, the sightseeing bridge that seems to float in the air, allows us to enjoy beautiful panoramic views of the Kremlin. Another attraction of this park is the media center, where cultural exhibitions are held, some large, with the most avant-garde display techniques. The Moscow Planetarium is a scientific and educational institution that also plays an excellent role as a tourist attraction. In 1929, the planetarium opened to the general public. It has the largest dome of stellar projections of Europe, the Sky Park, the Great Observatory, the Interactive Museum Lunarium, and the Uranium Museum.
Number 1, Novodevichy.
We are in the Novodevichy Monastery.
The Moscow Novodevichy female monastery was founded in 1524 by Basil III, the Grand Prince of Moscow. It was erected in memory of the annexation of Smolensk of 1514, which was more than a century under the government of Lithuania. The monastery is located on the lower shore of a picturesque curve of the Moskva River. It occupies a territory of 5 hectares, surrounded by thick walls, in which 12 towers stand out. Novodevichy's history is closely related to Russian royalty. Tsar Boris Godunov was crowned in the Cathedral of Our Lady of Smolensk in Novodevichy. The regent of Russia, Sofia Alexeyevna, was imprisoned in the Novodevichy Monastery by his stepbrother, Peter the Great, where she lived almost 15 years, and there she was buried in 1704. After several interruptions of monastic activity, in autumn 1994, the religious activity were reactivated again inside the walls of the convent. In 2004, the architectural ensemble of the Novodevichy Monastery has declared a World Heritage Site by UNESCO. The area currently occupied by the Novodevichy Cemetery was assigned to it at the end of the 19th century, in 1898. Many famous people are buried here. For example, the writers Nikolai Gogol, Anton Chekhov, Mikhail Bulgakov, Vladimir Mayakovsky, the well-known politicians Nikita Khrushchev and Boris Yeltsin, the businessman and patron Pavel Tretyakov, the stage director Konstantin Stanislavski, the military pilot Vitaly Popkov, and the actor and circus artist Yuri Nikulin, among others. We hope you liked our video and have discovered something new about Moscow. We invite you to send us your suggestions via YouTube or directly on our website, ciceroneplus.com.